Welcome, everybody. This is RetroPython with another LaunchBox tutorial. Today, we're diving into the fascinating world of classic adventure games with a look at ScummVM. ScummVM, or Script Creation Utility for Maniac Mansion Virtual Machine, is a powerful emulator that lets us play classic point-and-click adventure games on modern devices. It all started in 2001 when Ludwig Sergius, known as Ender, reverse-engineered the Scum engine originally used by LucasArts for those iconic games. Sergius is not only the creator of ScummVM, but also a prolific software developer known for his work on other significant projects. In 2005, he developed MuTorrent, one of the most widely used BitTorrent clients in the world. And in 2006, Sergius became the top engineer and developer at a new startup named Spotify. However, Sergius' journey hasn't been without challenges. He was diagnosed with a rare muscular disease called spinal muscular atrophy, which affects motor neuron functions and muscle strength. Despite this, he has made remarkable contributions to the software gaming community. Not all heroes wear capes. Initially, ScummVM aimed to bring those beloved games to platforms beyond DOS. Over time, it grew to support many other adventure game engines, including those from Sierra Online and Revolution Software. Today, ScummVM supports over 250 games across various platforms, making it a cornerstone of retro gaming. The community-driven project is constantly updated and improved by passionate developers and enthusiasts, ensuring these classic games remain accessible to new generations. ScummVM has become a vital tool for preserving and enjoying the rich history of adventure gaming, keeping these timeless titles alive and well for fans around the world. One of the most impressive aspects of ScummVM is its versatility. It runs on a wide range of devices, from modern PCs to Macs, smartphones, and even gaming consoles. This broad compatibility ensures that players can enjoy their favorite games anytime and anywhere. So whether you're a nostalgic gamer or a curious newcomer, ScummVM offers a gateway to a rich and rewarding world of interactive storytelling that's made even easier with the help of LaunchBox. Are you ready? Let's go! Before LaunchBox 13.15, setting up ScummVM felt like solving a Rubik's Cube blindfolded. You'd have to manually add the games and modify the ScummVM section. Now with LaunchBox 13.15, it's as easy as a file copy or a drag and drop. Spend less time fiddling and more time gaming. Let's start by using LaunchBox's auto import feature. I have a fresh install of LaunchBox. First, go to Tools, Options, and Automated Imports. Let's ensure that the Automated Import feature is activated. Now let's head over to Windows Explorer. I have my ScummVM games on my desktop. Let's take a quick look at the directory structure. Keeping your ROM files tidy is always smart, and ScummVM files are no exception. So when organizing your ROM files for ScummVM, maintaining a neat folder structure is key, especially since ScummVM can run games from various platforms. There are two recommended methods for organization. The first method is straightforward. Create a folder for each game and label it with the game name, followed by the system name in parentheses. For example, you might have a folder named Loom, CDFM Towns, or maybe even Sam & Max Hit the Road CD DOS. For those with multiple versions of the same game, there's a second method. Create a master folder named after the game. Inside this folder, organize different ROM files by naming each with the game title, followed by the system name in parentheses. This method shines when managing a game like Maniac Mansion, which has seen multiple iterations from the original Commodore 64 release to a fan-made enhanced Windows version and even the NES version. Yes, ScummVM plays them all. This organizational strategy not only keeps your library tidy, but also makes it easy to choose your preferred version of any iconic game. After all, it's no exaggeration to say that ScummVM was practically built for Maniac Mansion. The MM in ScummVM stands for it. Let's transfer our ScummVM files straight into our LaunchBox Games ScummVM directory. I have my ScummVM folder from my desktop open on the left and my LaunchBox Games ScummVM directory on the right. let's press Ctrl A to select all the ScummVM ROM folders. Now, let's drag and drop them into the LaunchBox Games ScummVM directory. Back in LaunchBox, you'll notice the auto import doing its magic. Say goodbye to manually adding your ScummVM games. Your ScummVM games are now integrated seamlessly. Now that we have imported our ScummVM ROMs into LaunchBox, it's time to play. Given that this is a new setup without any emulators installed, LaunchBox suggests we use ScummVM for playing ScummVM games. We'll go ahead and give LaunchBox a green light to install and configure ScummVM by clicking Yes, Please Install ScummVM. ScummVM is now installed. Let's take a look at Maniac Mansion. LaunchBox has imported all 10 of our Maniac Mansion ROMs, including the fan-made deluxe edition. But I am a softie when it comes to nostalgia, so let's try the OG Commodore 64 version. Back in the mid-1980s, Maniac Mansion was more than just a game on the Commodore 64. It was an adventure packed with mysteries. A treasure among the floppy disks that my friends and I would trade. We didn't just play in a physical world. Our exploration extended into this pixelated mansion full of puzzles and secrets. In those days, the internet was barely a whisper, with only QuantumLink around offering rudimentary online features. So gaming was more a personal or shared experience among friends. We had to rely on our wits to tackle the challenges Maniac Mansion presented, like the infamous puzzle of finding the key under the doormat, a simple yet elusive challenge that took me ages to figure out. The moment I discovered it, without any guides or forums, was a genuine triumph. This game wasn't just about solving puzzles. It was about immersing ourselves in a quirky, mysterious world with just a joystick and our sharp thinking. It taught me persistence and creativity, echoing beyond gaming into real-life challenges. Maniac Mansion on the Commodore 64 wasn't merely entertainment. It was a rite of passage that highlighted the joy of discovery and the deep satisfaction of overcoming seemingly small yet significant hurdles. ScummVM's keyboard setup mirrors that of the original game, which means the escape key likely skips cutscenes rather than exiting the game. You can use the original game's saving and loading keys. For instance, pressing F5 brings up the Maniac Mansion load save game screen, allowing you to manage your progress. Alternatively, you can use ScummVM's default shortcut, Control F5, to access the ScummVM menu. Here you can load, save, and exit your game. When saving your game, you'll find that you have virtually unlimited save slots available. To exit your ScummVM ROM, you can press Ctrl F5, bring up the ScummVM menu, and select Quit. Alternatively, you can hit Ctrl Z to quit. If your ScummVM ROM is a Windows-based ROM, hit Alt F4 to quit. Now, let's install our ScummVM ROMs using the drag-and-drop method. We're going to drag and drop our ScummVM files directly into LaunchBox. I have a fresh install of LaunchBox. Let's head over to Windows Explorer. I have my ScummVM games on my desktop. Let's start by pressing Ctrl A to select all our ScummVM ROM folders. Next, simply drag and drop them into LaunchBox. This will prompt the Import Games from Files wizard. Select the option for ROM files. We're setting up the ScummVM platform. Since this is a new installation of LaunchBox and ScummVM hasn't been configured yet, LaunchBox offers to install and configure it for us automatically. Let's go ahead and do that. I'll keep these files on my desktop for now, but you can choose any option you prefer. I'm selecting all options to fully enhance my LaunchBox and Big Box experience. This choice ultimately depends on how much hard drive space you're willing to allocate for additional media. If you have an Emu Movies account, now it's time to set it up and download extra files. Let's keep the default settings and click Next. Here's the list of ROM files we're importing. LaunchBox will now proceed to import these files and download the selected metadata. 9 games imported successfully, 42 media files downloaded. Let's play. Let's dive into another one of my favorite LucasArts classics, Zach McKracken and the Alien Mindbenders. Originally, I played this on the Commodore 64, but this time, I've opted to import the FM Towns Marty version. The beauty of these iconic games is their availability across various platforms. You can choose to import the version that resonates most with you, whether it's the one that brings back the most nostalgia, or simply the one you think is the best. Or, why not import them all and enjoy the differences? After the whirlwind adventure of Maniac Mansion, my friends and I were eager for what came next. Then came Zach McKracken and the Alien Mindbenders, and we were instantly hooked. This game, often considered a spiritual successor to Maniac Mansion, delivered another thrilling point-and-click adventure that LucasArts was becoming famous for. Set in a zany world where Zach, a tabloid reporter, must thwart the bizarre plans of brain-sapping aliens, it expanded on the innovative gameplay and humor that we loved in Maniac Mansion. Using the Scum engine, just like its predecessor, Zach McKracken allowed us to engage in the story with intuitive mechanics and clever puzzles that required real teamwork to solve. This game wasn't just a sequel in spirit. It was a whole new adventure that brought us together, eager to defeat the quirky alien threat and save the Earth. As we navigated through the game's global escapades, from the pyramids of Egypt to the depths of Atlantis, every session ended with plans for the next. Zach McKracken was more than just a game. It was a continuation of our shared journey through the imaginative world crafted by LucasArts. And each moment was a thrilling step into the unknown. Here's a useful tip. Since the release of LaunchBox 13.13, we've added a version and status field to the Manage Emulators section. Use this to check for updates to your emulators. For example, our ScummVM is currently at version 2.8.1, which was released in March. If a new version were available, the checkmark would change to a cloud icon. You would simply double-click the cloud, click Update, and LaunchBox will download and install the latest version for you. Before we wrap up this video, let's address a question we've been getting a lot of. How do I change the ROM folders that LaunchBox automatically imports from? Well, currently the simplest method is to set up the platform you're importing from manually. First, don't forget to head up to Tools, Options, and enable those auto imports. Next, navigate back to Tools, then Manage, and select Platforms. Here we'll add the ScummVM platform manually. Choose to scrape as ScummVM. Let's hit OK. You'll see that the default folder for ScummVM is listed as Games, ScummVM. Let's change that by clicking Edit, then Folders, and browse to where your ScummVM files are stored. In my case, I'll navigate to my R drive, ScummVM. Click OK. LaunchBox will then ask you if you want to move any ROMs located in the game's ScummVM directory to the new location. Choose what best fits your setup. Since I have games already in this folder, LaunchBox will auto-import them. Now that LaunchBox has imported all the games from that folder, let's add something new. I have my R drive ScummVM ROMs folder on my left, and a bunch of ScummVM ROMs I have yet imported on the right. Let's choose something different, a non-LucasArts game. How about the Seventh Guest? Let's drag and drop it over. Seventh Guest copying. Let's head back into LaunchBox, and since we changed that ScummVM default folder, Seventh Guest is now imported. Let's test it out. Since we manually added the ScummVM platform, LaunchBox will remind us that we need to install ScummVM. Let's have LaunchBox download and install it. Once ScummVM is downloaded and installed, let's try the Seventh Guest one more time. There you go. The Seventh Guest, released in 1993, quickly became a cultural phenomenon and a pioneer in the puzzle adventure genre. One of the first games to be released on CD-ROM, it showcased the potential of this new medium with its rich graphics and full motion video. This game captivated audiences with its immersive horror narrative and chilling soundtrack, setting a new standard for interactive storytelling. Its influence is evident in many narrative-driven games that followed. Over the years, The Seventh Guest has been made available on numerous platforms, ensuring that new generations can experience its iconic puzzles and eerie ambiance. This accessibility has solidified its place in the annals of pop culture and the video gaming community. Now, with the help of ScummVM and LaunchBox, it's even easier to play.
He was a drifter.
As we turn the page on the seventh guest, let's turn the page on his video. As always, questions or comments, leave them down below. This is RetroPython for LaunchBox. Until next time, happy gaming.